My name is Longjum Sushil Kumar. I am an English teacher and I'll be teaching class 11 and 12 general English. And today I am going to teach a lesson from prose sections of class 12 general English, that is an anthology of English prose and poetry. And the name of the lesson is The Kite Maker by Ruskin Bond. Before we jump directly to the text, or before we come to the text, I just want to give you a brief biography of the author Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond was born in the year 1934. He is an Indian author of British descent, in a very simple English, Anglo-Indian. He has written number of novels and several short stories. He was awarded the Sahitya Academy Award in 1992, the Padma Shri Award in 1999, and the Padma Bhushan in 2014. He also won John Llewellyn Rich Prize for his novel Room on Roof in the year 1957. Now, coming to the text, or coming to the lesson, the whole story, The Kite Maker, the whole story is centered to a character by the name Muhammad. And therefore, Muhammad is the eponym. Eponym means a name or a noun that is formed, F-O-R-M-E-D, formed after someone. So, Muhammad is the eponym of Ruskin Bond's short story, The Kite Maker. This story expresses the sorrow one feels at the passing of an ace, especially the ace of simplicity and dignity. And the story is a contrast between the past golden era and the present era, new era of sweet changing world. And in this story, we have themes of tradition, mortality, happiness, loneliness, and of course, chains. These are the themes that we have in this story. Now, let me come to the text. My dear students, I am going to read out the text and I am going to explain each and every line in your text. Now, let me start. An ancient banyan which had grown through the cracks of an abandoned moat was the only tree in the street known as Gali Ram Nath, and little Ali's kite had caught in its branches. This is the first paragraph of the lesson. So, in a street called Gali Ram Nath, there is only one tree there, and it is the ancient banyan tree. And this tree actually grown out of the crack of an abandoned moat. And in the last class also, I said that I'll be using bilingual Manipuri and English so that students can understand the lesson very well. Now coming to Manipuri translation. I always say that translation is a very difficult work, but let me try my level best so as to make you understand the lesson very easily. Gali Ram Nath Hairiba Lerakshida Subnadagi Hauriba Upam Bisi Ariba Kungang Pambiduni Hairiba Kungang Pambisi Mayam Nalai Khoiram Nadraba Musulman Singi Dungba Laisang Mox Amagi Chekhaiba crack amadagi haurak kiba adugma khongrang pambi du khaktani aduga haiba khongrang pambi ji gi masada pikliba ali ali gi maha ki telanga do palmi hebe masigi the first paragraph can you see paragraphs ne kari tawi masina ngasai gi stories gi settings the setting of the story ji must describe yam phajina tawi. Now let me come to the second paragraph. The boy barefoot and clad, clad, hybrid, C-L-A-D, clad. The meaning of clad is dress, wearing. Okay, you P-set, but only in a thrown shirt, ran along the cobblestones. Cobblestones means small, small round stones of the narrow street to where his grandfather sat nodding dreamily. Nodding dreamily in the sunshine of their back courtyard. Now, let me explain the second paragraph. The boy Ali, his description is given in the second paragraph. The boy is barefooted and clad or dressed only in a torn shirt. This shows that Ali belongs to a poor family. From the description of his dress, we come to know that this little boy Ali belongs to a poor family. And he ran through the cobblestones of the narrow street to where his grandfather sat nodding dreamily in the sunshine of their back courtyard. Courtyard hai bide koina maiteron dha gadi sumang hai bide sumang ji maning sumang mamang sumang in the back courtyard aduna says the hai bun pamasa khungo phena tong da ba sumna dagi phuri chegai ba mag lit paduna hai ba lambi dugi akhu ba lambi dugi lerak to da nunglak to da chela ami kara kara yong na chela iba maha ki madouna nungsa da makhoigi yumdugi maningi sumangda uireduna mangak nomduna leiriba madogi manak tamna sela mi haibani. So from this paragraph I again said that it describes the boy, and from the description of the boy we come to know that the boy actually he doesn't belongs to a rich family, he belongs to a poor family. This is very much connected. You will come to know more in the course of the lesson. Now, grandfather shouted, boy, the kite has gone. So the boy called out to his grandfather saying that his kite has gone. In the first paragraph I have already mentioned ko ngasai han mada hai re, his kite was caught in the branches of the banyan tree. Adana madau du mana he is reporting to his grandfather, informing his grandfather that his kite has gone ko ido nupa masaduna lauramme aigi telanga do pangre haibani mangre diya da na pangre haibani. The old man, now coming the next line, the old man woke from his daydream with start haidi se koi start ni start an how do na tis tela aina koi gi start an exclamation na khang laga hai. So the old man woke from his daydream with his start, raising his head, displayed at the short over a beard at the koi which would have been white had it not been dyed red with mehendi leaves. Now in these two lines, the author Ruskin Bond actually give the description of the old man Muhammad ki magi description ni ko sai ji ahal loira banu pado ma ki masunu pado na korpa da khangla du na yeng khallami hebni mag thangal ami mag na mag thangal pada kari ulami ma ki makoi karamba stage the phajana palli ko kari gumba mehendi sangam da batar gadi. Mehendi is a Hindi word ni koi seng na is a color used to dye our hair or beard ni ko adaga hai ba mehendi sangam da batar gadi pungong ngorum ga da ba hai bani. This shows that the old man, the man mentioned here is a very old man ko magi beard to white ore da bu ma mehendi sangbagi magi color do lady hai bani ko. Did the twine break, he asks. So the grandfather asks to his grandson Ali or the little boy, did the twine of the kite break? Have ni ka have the twine have this like a thread to ni akhoi gi telanga da har kana yam simple akhoi gi manipuri gi dialect har kana akhoi gi pukli kai do telanga gi pukli kai do pukli do tali bra have ni ka. I know that kite twine is not what it used to be. Yam phajaba explanation is still aise ai khangi hai bani. That means the old man knows that the kite twine actually now is being used is not as strong as they used to use when he was young hai bani still aise sina takpade ai khangi ne telanga du gi pukli do thaine gi damaina kandra bani hai bani shole hai bani. So in the introduction of the lesson I have already said that the story is a contrast between the old era or the age and the new era of swift changing world. Hongai ba no era asiga
hogiba era past and the present ani si blind toroga chatpadu ma story mani ekhoi na jiknei nari sikau. Next up, no grandfather, the kite is stuck in the banyan tree. So the boy answered to his grandfather stating that his kite actually was caught in the branches of the tree. He has lost his kite not because the twine of the kite was broken. Mana explain to pani natte aigi telanga do pugli tat laga mangi ba natte aigi telanga do ugi masada panmani. This is the explanation given by the boy to his grandfather. The old man chuckled. Chuckle means laugh five bani. Yam light when a coin a haha kind of something no pa. Yam laun no pusunataba. Adugumudubunika. Hi, but the old man chuckled. You have yet to learn how to fly a kite properly, my child. So the old man said that his little grandson actually is yet to learn how to fly the kite properly. This is what the old man said. And I am too old to teach you. That is the pity of it. Then the old man further added that he is now too old and he cannot teach his grandson how to fly the kite properly, and it is the pity on his part. Hai bani ko ai su yam ahal loire nangbu telanga phajna tambi paiba tambi bodo madusu ngamdre masimak ai gi nungai tabani. This is what the grandfather said to his grandson. But you shall have another. But the grandfather assured to his grandson that he is going to have another kite, and he has given this assurance. Mana hai re adubu karim khalu nonang atopa telanga ma dangi leigani ham. He had just finished here. He stationary ba kano se ko gi pronoun he se Muhammad old man dubuni ko se ja ko na pa matam da ko gi pronoun sing ji ko gi ya ri ba non pronoun ji yamna clearly ko understand tong na bona ga da bani. He have se Muhammad old man dubuni. He had just finished making a new kite from bamboo, paper and tin silk, and it lay in the sun firming it up. So from this part of the story we come to know that the old man had just finished making a new kite, and now it is laying framing in the sun. So this is the kite he is going to give to his grandson. Maitironda in a Manipuri translation man hairse karino have the hairi ba hanasina akoi bamboo dagi wa dagi silk dagi toroga telanga ma saba loire hairi ba telanga se nungsa da phoduna leibne. This is the kite he is going to present to his grandson. Therefore he assured to his grandson that he will have another new kite. Sinis the laisika. Now okay. It was a pale pink kite. Description of the kite in new kite to me, with a small green tail. The old man handed it to Ali, and the boy raised himself on his toes and kissed his grandfather's hollow out cheek. So the boy was so happy when his grandfather presented him at the new kite, and therefore he stood up and he, before leaving, he kissed his grandfather hollow out cheek. Habidi angang yam harau re maha madau duna telanga do prekpada maha yam thuna hugalami aduka maha ki madau gi kusal laba khajai do supirami. Habidi this is how the little boy show his gratitude to his grandfather for giving him a new kite. I will not lose this one, he said. The kite will fly like a bird. So the boy again exclaimed that he is never going to lose the kite that his grandfather has presented to him, and he was very sure that the new kite will fly like a bird. Mr. Lai si mahang na hai si masim da ei manghal la roi masigi telanga si uche kum na pai ra kani hai bagi angang du da phogja ba nungai ba excitement adu bunis da koi si lines da uri se. And he turned on his heels and skipped out of the courtyard. And after saying this, the boy ran out of the courtyard happily. Amai todra maha khuning thangkatuna haiba mapham du dege habidi sumang du dege maha sento khirami with the new kite anuba telanga de loina. Similar siboksina koi gi I have already said the story actually is a blint of the past and the present. How giba amu adige hajik present gi oiba post se blend to have the mix tor tor ga set pani amuk next paragraph se da mu yeng si the old man remain dreaming in the sun ahal lor banu pado numit nungsadu da adumak mang mang duna le howi have ni day dreaming ni silai je nungdangi dream du dina te ko his kite shop had gone the premises having been sold many years ago to a junkie dealer from this part of the story we are going to learn the past of this old man mohammed mohammed ki magi how yo punsi sini koi na swai de khanga duise ma mang mang duna le howi hai maha ki so from this line we come to know that mohammed once had a kite shop but it is no longer it had gone and hai resta the even the premises the area where his kite shop was it was sold to a junkyard haveni maha ki telanga gi adugumba dukan do hajiti leitre satkre mapham du su adugumba koncha ki business to ba yo junk dealer mada yon thokre haveni sina nga mohammed ki magi hau yo pulsi dune koina khak tuise but he still made kites for his own amusement amusement here means pleasure and as playthings playthings means in a very simple English we can term it as toy for his grandson but the old man still makes kite it is quite question why did the old man still makes kite and hang if this questions is asked must hang pata agi yam simple answer ina he still makes the kite for his own amusement pleasure and as a plaything for his grandson ali have ni ma hajik chu telanga sari si ma gi yona banatre hajik ti now he is making the kite for his own enjoyment and as a plaything for his little ali hai ta di ma ki pigli ba masunu padu gi sana pot oina ba gi dang ta ma telanga hajik chu sari have sina sina answer ro ge da ba now not many people bought kites these days nowadays many people did not buy kites and the reason is given here hajik kandi mi ana mana koi telanga se leinadre hai why have the sigi following lines te koi na khangbanga mane adul disdain them disdain have the dislike or hated have ni ed ni past form ni laije and children prefer to spend their money at the movies the reason number 1 is adul dislike flying kites or kites and they prefer or the young people nowadays prefer to spend their money in movies rather than to buy kites or to fly kites this is number 1 reason why people stop buying kites nowadays now in continuation moreover second reason moreover there were few open spaces left for flying kites and a second reason is now at present there is no space for flying kite adugi mathakta hajikti telanga paina badugumba ahang mum phom du su leitre hebeni the city had swollen up the green maidan maidan actually is a hindi word in english translation it means ground a big ground dubuni which had strays from the old fort walls to the river bank that means there is no space to fly kite but earlier there was a space from this line we come to know that there was a space and the space was so vast okay it extended from the old fort wall up to the river bank have the ngasai gi ningthau gi adugumba ariba phaglang du dagina adudagi hauraga akogi turen mapan bokta pak sanna adugumba lampa ama leremi tobadabu hojik ti hajik prajendang la ayuje hojik ti sahar on grebni stage da kona the city had swollen up the green maidan have se kona translation je phajana trok pata agadi swollen and have yoshan bai bani adubo kona real translation da halak pata agadi now the space the ground that used to be in the past is no longer now because that space has now become a city city own grey have ni sigi porch ni stela ise ka